Alright, what's up, guys? I'm good. Did any of you guys watch the rap of China?
Yeah.
Actually?
Yeah.
Who do you guys like more? Do you guys like Guy or PG1 more?
PG1!
Alright. Oh, yeah. So, I'm gonna do a song by PG1. It's called Zhou Mar Bing. But I've never actually rapped in Chinese before, so just, you know, lower the stance a little bit. Alright, let's hit it.
Thank you.
Sit on my lap, no. something else, but I know what you're really here for. You came here to hear the legend of the Nian. But now, first, a few ground rules. Feel free to take pictures, but make sure your flash is off and your phone or camera doesn't make any of that annoying shutter noise. Also, keep your phone on silent. Not vibrate, just keep that noise off. We can be a noisy show, but we do have our quiet moments, which are easily ruined if about 20 different ringtones go off at the same time. Violators of these rules will be fed to the dreadful Nian, which is always very hungry after a year of hibernation. And now, please enjoy the 2018 CUSA Culture Show.
The Chinese New Year begins Friday, February 16, 2018. Mark your calendars.
Also known as the Spring Festival, the celebration lasts 15 days.
You may already know of the traditions of the Chinese New Year. Painting red lanterns at the house, for instance.
Lighting firecrackers or fireworks.
Watching the lion dance at the parade. But how do such traditions start?
This is the story of the Chinese New Year.
The true tale of how it all began.
Well, I mean, not really. This is based on one version of the story. There are like 20 different versions out there. And man, this one took a lot of liberties. They drew this all from a 5-sentence
We now ask you to accept us as a troupe of actors, your peers, telling this story. All of us, as ourselves, telling you, the audience, the story of the Chinese New Year, and occasionally stepping in to portray the roles the story requires.
So we're acting.
SG. We're acting.
Very confusing. Okay, keep going.
We ask you to imagine a village in the mountains of China.
Led by a stoic clan chief.
Inhabited by its peaceful villagers, making ends meet, growing crop, tending cattle.
They live a peaceful, carefree life, lacking worries and hardships. Except, of course, for the dreadful Nian, a malicious beast that lived outside the village, sitting at the body of a bull and the head of a lion.
No one ever caught a glimpse of the creature and lived to tell the tale.
Well, obviously not no one, then you wouldn't know.
Once, every year, in the dead of winter, the Nian comes out of his hiding and feed on whatever it can find.
Being so close to the village, it inevitably bends its way to their fields and eats their crops. The villagers dread the Nian's annual attack.
Rather than fight, they choose to cower in fear, for they believe direct confrontation means certain death.
As the villagers hide, the Nian storms into town, eats their crops, and destroys their property.
And once it has had its fill, it returns into the mountains once more. Then, the villagers return to their carefree lives as they count the month until the Nian returns.
The villagers take no joy from this annual. But they have no desire for a hero, since many a warrior, raised to strength or just passing by, has tried and failed to defeat the horror creature.
Perhaps victory lies with another.
Perhaps victory comes from the most unexpected places.
From the younger, reckless soul.
Street pavers of the region. And over here, We have some of the finest doctors of the era, guaranteed to rid you of illnesses within just a few months, thanks to a few herbs and needles. Cutting edge, I tell you! And over here... Oh, actually, the tour can end here.
Oh? And why is that? Are you proud of our illustrious farmers? Look at all the good work they do, growing crops that go straight into the mouth of the monster, the Nian. If it good work then, why don't I take the ring from here? She's right, you know. The village has little spirit these days. Nobody tries to defend the crop from that savage creature. Nobody but Gwen.
Sorry,
Austin. Where are you off to, Ren?
I can't stay for too long. If Mother finds out I left the house unattended...
Ren, what are you doing out of it? She found out.
Hi, Mother.
I thought I told you to finish your chores.
I did.
Did you? That child who made the death of us all with his wild plans. I suppose I'd better go home and fix whatever mess he left.
I can keep an eye on him for you in case he comes by again.
Fine. But don't you go putting any ideas into his head like last time. It took 2 weeks for everything to dry after that flood.
The flood. You know, if Ren had done all of that correctly, he very well might have invented indoor plumbing. But alas, we're going to have to wait for the Europeans to make the right advancements. In a few thousand years.
Is she gone?
Yes. Now, would you mind telling me what in the world you're up to this time?
What do you mean, this time? I'll tell you later.
If you haven't guessed, that was our main character. The unsuspecting hero of this story, my disciple Ren. Full of youthful vigor and spirit, and sometimes naivete,
which can get on the nerves of his best friends, Jean.
And Lee. Stone bricks? Mud bricks? No, thatched fences.
Hi, Ren. You are actually out of belt for once.
Jean, Ling! And finish your chores already? If you know enough to ask, you know enough to answer. Ha. What are you doing?
Really?
I've been thinking. No. Why do we let the Nian roam through our village every year?
Because generations before us have tried everything and no one's been able to stop it.
Well, I have an idea.
Oh god, this is gonna go the way of the flood.
Hey, the flood was not my fault!
It kind of was.
Okay, anyway, so look. The Nian's behavior is predictable. Every year, it enters through the village on the eastern edge, the part facing the mountains. So I'm thinking maybe we could, build an obstacle around it. The city, build something to deter the Nian,
So, build a fence.
Exactly!
The Nian's been terrorizing us forever. What makes you think someone hasn't tried and built this city?
Well, see, I asked Melos about that.
Oh, and we're listening to the Loony Lady.
Hey, I trust the Loony Lady's advice over my own mother's.
Hey, Link, that's not very nice. Your mother's a wonderful lady.
Look, I don't question it. Anyway, so I asked Melos about building a fence. But apparently half a century ago, they built a barrier using mud. The Nian just dug right through it. They considered building a fence, but no one was crazy enough to go to the forest to get the wood.
No one except for you, I take it.
Exactly. So here's what we're gonna do.
We?
Yeah. You? Me? Ling? We're gonna go out to the forest tonight and get a whole bunch of wood! We're gonna start building the fence, like proof of concept. If the rest of the village likes it, we can finish it. Sounds like a plan! Yeah!
Have you gone nuts? There's no way this could work. Besides, you don't have an axe.
My father had one. Maybe my mom kept it around with
her. But he was out. Knowing her mom? I don't think so.
Well, it's not like she would have told me. She doesn't want me leaving the house half the time and I...
But,
I have to go home.
Someone forgot his chores.
Shut up! Look, if I can't find an axe at home, maybe I can borrow one from somebody.
Something's not right inside.
I don't know. If he's crazy enough to risk it, Maybe he's crazy enough to get it done.
What do you think? Can a solid fence really keep out a creature that's been terrorizing the village for decades? Is this idea brilliant or thick-headed? Can you build a wall and make the Nian pay for it? We'll see about that. Attention to the household of our hero, where the mother keeps a tight lid on her son. Overprotective as it were, telling your child never to go out is only going to increase desires to explore. Bad parenting if you ask me.
Who asked you?
I'm just saying.
Kuching, are you home?
Well, I know for a fact you're not.
Sorry, Kuching. I know I was supposed to finish, but...
Let me guess. You had another one of your ideas.
Well...
How many times have I told you not to go until you finish your chores? Look at you, making an old woman do the job you should have done yourself.
But you give me so many chores, and the ground doesn't even need sweeping. You're just doing it to guilt me.
Ren, I know it's difficult living under this roof, but I really need to know where you are. I know how bad this place gets when they don't get their back.
But... Uncle Chen, do you by any chance have an axe that I could borrow?
Nope.
He definitely had an axe. Oh, Miss Anne, by any chance do you have an axe that I could use for something cool? The blood was not my fault.
But I also do know that you have a little bit of history of trouble.
thin on ice.
No, she's right. No one's gonna trust me with that. Not with my history.
Didn't you say your dad had one?
Yeah. My mother would tell me what an axe is.
Why not?
I don't remember.
Wait! I have a dual name. Why don't I ask someone for an axe? And then just give it to you?
Oh my god!
You're brilliant!
I just remember you having a real problem with lying.
I don't. Just keep watch. Hypo, hypo, come on! Go get him! Get him!
Sir!
Yes?
That was certainly so, so productive.
I couldn't do it. I would disgrace the family name forever.
Face it, Ren. The only person who's crazy enough to land me that is that May woman.
Brilliant idea. Let's go get Milosin. Come on!
Wait, what? No!
A boy forced to live at home all the time does not make a lot of friends. Those two are the only other children willing to put up with his antics. You may think that the villagers were unnecessarily mean to our dear Ren, and I suppose they were. But things were not always like that. Once upon a time, everything was quite different.
Make no mistake. Life in the village was never content with the looming presence of the Nian. But it is much easier to lead a normal life when the attacks are personal.
Come along now, Ren.
Where are we going, Mama?
Today, I'm gonna show you how to chop the tree.
Dear, do you really think he needs to know that now?
Chopping trees builds character.
Alright. But be back before sundown. I won't risk the two of you out at night with the dreadful Nian's talking about.
A family of three. A mother, a son, and yes, a father. A father whose presence you may have noticed is absent today.
Okay, Red. Trees are very important to us because we use them to burn our fires and build our homes. But we can't just go around chopping every tree from left to right.
How do we know which tree to cut?
We need a good strong tree that will provide a solid foundation if we want to build a house. So we're going to become very familiar with this tree. We're going to actually build a bond of friendship with it.
A bond of friendship?
Yeah, so what I do before cutting a tree is I go and hug it.
Hug the tree? Mama, don't be silly. The tree doesn't hug you back.
Of course it doesn't. That's because it's scared of being chopped down. Alright, you give it a try. Well?
Mama, I think you're just teasing me now.
Possible. But actually though, trees are very important for us, and they symbolize longevity. And we are cutting its life short when we cut it down.
Okay.
Now, give it a good swing.
Tomorrow, yes. Well, don't count.
annual visit, so Ren never got a chance to return to the woods with his father.
And as the days passed, the young child grew more and more impatient, until finally, he decided to take matters into his own hands. One night, he stole his father's axe and went out to the woods.
Alright, Tree. You look just as big as the one Baba chopped down. So you are going to be my first tree-cutting time awesome tree cut. Alright, Tree. Get ready. Whoa! That was weird. Okay. Now, I'll chop you down.
What? Why is this so hard?
What was it, Baba? He hugged the tree. Come here, you.
What is the name of a young child?
Alright, tree. Now I'm gonna chop you down.
happening, Mei-Losu?
What are we doing in this loony lady's house again?
The loony lady may have a bad back, but her hair's just peachy. Thank you very much.
Jin, respect your elders. Hello again, Mei-Losu.
So what brings you three to my humble abode?
Well, Ren here has some half-baked plan to keep the Nian out of the village.
Hey!
Do you now? Is that what you were muttering on about earlier?
Whoa, I was just thinking. Maybe we could build a fence around the village. That way the Nian can't come in and hurt us.
Yes, and that way we can all live our lives fenced in, like she.
Jin, my apologies, Mei-Losu.
Anyway, we just need to gather wood to help build the fence. But no one's willing to help us. But we can always count on you. Please, Mei-Losu.
Please, Mei-Losu.
Yes, please!
Begin by gripping the handle firmly, and then swinging like a praying mantis.
What was going on? What are you doing? Put that away! You're next!
Planning to use it today, be careful. There's supposed to be a thunderstorm tonight.
Okay, I'm not sure if that'll work, but it'll do.
be chopping a lot of trees down. Maybe just one. Maybe just one of them.
That sounds good. Okay.
But I admit, I'm a little rusty.
Oh, like that axe, huh?
Ha ha. No. The last time I used this axe was about 7 years ago, actually.
You've used Melosh's axe before?
I don't think it's her axe.
He had suspected it the moment he laid eyes on it. It stays no longer in that house.
In fact, the last time I used this axe was the night that...
The night that what?
Did you hear that?
Ren, the night that what happened?
Okay.
Oh no! I remember now. Remember what?
It was the night that my father died.
Paralysis and memories from that wretched night came flooding back. Ren could only remain still.
Ren, get out of the way! We need to make a break for the village!
Ren, move!
Oh, Ren!
Ren remembered what his father had done for him all those years ago!
Raising his axe, he struck it against Nian's flash, causing it to let go of Corling's leg.
But the Nian was undeterred. He made another charge. He was about to make him heal on Ren when all of a sudden...
A bolt of lightning from the storm struck the tree, setting it ablaze.
We just made it mad, but we have to go now.
Link, talk to me, are you okay?
Would it make you feel better if I lied?
Can you walk?
Just go on without me. You'll never make it out.
Not an option, buddy. Hey, Ren, got any more of those axes?
You know I don't.
I need a weapon.
Intermission time. Go grab a snack, run to the bathroom, update your snack stories, and we'll see you after the intermission. Don't call strange dogs, yeah? We're not really here, anyways. Toodles!
Thank you.
When we last left off, our three heroes, they had just survived a near fatal attack by the Nian. They stumbled back home, praying that the Nian had not followed them.
Do you think we got it off our trail?
I don't know, but we have to go to Nian soon.
Right, the Nian always attacks on the same day, always. It's never delivered. Oh, Ling!
We need to take him to Melos now. She'll know what to do.
Do you think we'll be okay?
Yeah.
Ah, that must be our young field returning from their heroic journey. I wonder how it went.
Please, Melos, hurry up!
Did Jin just use honor mythics? The world must be ending. The world was ending. Life on the table! Now! Let the world rise on the staff. It will help numb the pain.
Safe at last. Oh,
Spoke too soon, huh?
Thought friendly were his mind. How could he possibly defeat Nian armed with only his axe?
It only made him mad before. There had to be something else he could use.
Faces were dead, friend panicked, and did the only thing that came to mind.
Arg! To his surprise, the Nian retreated at the sound of his scream.
But he recovered just as quickly. Ren, still unsure what the hell just happened, decided he was better off running again.
In his haste, he knocks over a train of firecrackers.
The
firecrackers spill into his pack, and he trips.
There's my idea.
The Nian lunges, undeterred.
Thinking quickly, he flung the firework at the Nian. Hey Nian! Over here! Look at me, tasty chop! Alright for the picking! Ren, look at firecracker!
If you're the only one willing to face up to Nian like this, then
probably it's time we took your side. Whatever you need, we can give.
When we were in the woods, the Nian was ready to gobble us up, but there was a storm and lightning struck a tree, and it ran away.
Yeah. And when I used your firecrackers just now, the Nian, it couldn't have been a few feet from chopping my head off, but it cowered at the noise.
Right, and when I waved the torch at it, it freaked out too. It must have been aversion to fire or something too.
Everyone, grab whatever you can find and make a loud noise. Pots, pans, firecrackers, anything. The Nian will strike again. This time, maybe we can scare it into running away.
What? You guys have a better plan?
I'll wait!
Anyone? Alright, Kel, let's go find a Nian.
Alright!
In the meantime, I'm sure you all are tired. 恭喜发财, Happy New Year!